the next thing I hear that will be amazing. Everything from what we build is done by hand. This explains why this place is so shallow.
Okay, folks, so we've safely joined the River Bure, which we'll be following for the duration. We've just left one of the oldest boat yards on the Broads, which was founded in 1870 called John Mons.
It's amazing, isn't it? The garden's almost as big as mine. We have some grey leg geese there on the right hand side. These are native to Britain, and they're called grey legs because, well,
words did you see so far, Kavya? Can you spell them?
No. Wait, Swan. Common Town. My large ducks. Black-headed blue.
Okay.
Offers a variety of sailing activities for the complete novice to the more experienced sailor.
The club holds races here every weekend from Easter till the end of October. But the last week of July is a very important date on their calendar, here every day of that week. And it has...
back in the village, I mentioned that I'm going to show you an example of the three waves. Now, right on the side here, you can see the very small ones on the right. And even smaller one on the left side, so you can as well. Now, larger reef bases are still housed in the doors. This lot of the vast quantities that they see nowadays comes from overseas, from countries such as Turkey and Poland.
Jack, do you want ice cream?
Now, when reed is harvested,
so, wherever reeds grow along the bank,
they absorb these waves like a buffer, so it cannot be eroded.
And this is one of the reasons why we have such low speed. Very soon you might be able to see a secret broad.
This tiny broad is called the Polk, and it's only visible
from the entire village of Wood Pascoe. How's this broad, along with many others around here, is close to the public. The broad is the back here. More adventurous people might even venture for a paddle or a swim from the sand.
Just stay here with me, Alf.
This brings us on to Sandhouse Modification. Most broads I mentioned earlier were dug out. But Sandhouse Broad is an exception to the rule and was dug in the 9th century for its gravel and sand. And this was intended as building materials for churches, halls, and other buildings of high importance. In fact, Wroxham's very own St Mary's Church was built from the material dug out from this.
This board is very bad.
Why?
Because it's bad.
You don't so that.
Puppy.
Where?
It is puppy.
Where? Swear to me?
Okay.
Oh, it's not
Bobby.
Dead.
Yeah! Let's go, Kavya and Zak.